this when I was on tour in Japan last year. I think my guitar tech had just bought a new guitar, and so he brought it to my room for fun so I could play with his new guitar. And I was just playing really loud in my dressing room when I wrote the song, and then this was the perfect vehicle for it because I'm not on tour now, and this is what I'm doing now. So I thought we'd try it, and the girls were down. And then whenever I played with them, it was just like, oh, yeah, this feels right.
Right on, totally.
We have a tendency for really sad, beautiful, beautiful songs, and I think we just wanted to try and
write some more upbeat songs.
Yes. It was nice to throw this one in because it kept it from, the tempos from being all too slow.
6 degrees of separation.
Honestly, I wrote that song for this band. I started that song when I had the great fortune of playing guitar for Nora on tour for her record The Fall, which I think was 2 albums ago. And anyway, I started writing that song on that tour. And by the time I recorded Aquarius, both of these girls were on the road. Nora was on her second and her last album, I think, on tour, and Catherine was with Grace or with Jack White. It was like everybody was gone. And I still felt like that was part of the record. Anyway, so when we got to this, when the timing made sense and it really started to come together to record the album, this made sense, fortunately, to do that song. And then when we recorded it here, that was the first time I was like, that is what I was trying to write. And so that is like that was like a really cool experience for a new writer like myself. Really cool to get to do that.
A few years ago, I had a really slow winter, and somebody dropped a pedestal off at my house, and I said, I don't want this, but they refused to take it, and instead I learned how to play it. And so I learned from that maybe when times are slow, instead of doing things that are not so fulfilling, learning something new, so I decided to learn a little guitar, and I decided to maybe finish some of the songs that I had started or start something else. So the song Always is, I decided that I wanted to write a real simple song. It wasn't about my feelings or anything sad. It was just sort of a fun song. I said, I want to write an earworm that people can just dance to.
But you brought that tune to this band.
God, I mean, this was back when we were first starting out, before I had the great fortune of meeting Kat, we were playing with Sloppy Joanne's.
Yeah,
and a friend from Smalls who heard I was playing a little guitar on the side, John Roach.
He turned me on to
Will Ryder, and and then it just became one of our songs.
That song ended up on featuring just because Sasha was in my band and we did it as an extra tune for iTunes, and that was the only version we had of it. We didn't mean to exclude you, but that was the only version we had of that tune, so we threw it on featuring. But we've always done that song in this band.
I sent Pontus to them, and they were both like, wow, that's great, let's try it. And I said, really?
Really? I was just looking for sort of feedback, like, you can do it. Keep up the good work.
Oh my God.
They were like, let's play
do it.
It.
And I play fiddle. You let me play fiddle on it.
I love when we try, because that's the thing, so many of our songs are getting actually polished, so we try to incorporate one or two songs a set where we can still, where there is a, it can still potentially fall apart, which I know our audience loves, and I love too. I love like that sort of, that feeling of edginess and like, what the hell is going to happen? Like, what? Anything could happen.
What did she just say?
That happens a lot.
You'll Forget Me was one of my first songs that I ever wrote, but it wasn't on my last record because...
It was on your EP.
It was on my EP.
Before that.
Yeah, that's right. God, that was at Nora's home studio in 2007.
Yeah. Yeah, we just liked it, so we brought it back.
Yeah. That's standard form.
It sounds like you've turned on the radio and an old pickup truck, and the song's already started. Like the way, that, I don't know, there's something about.
Thanks.
Yeah, it's, I just love this.
We were doing the Bridge School. I did the Bridge School like 6 years ago. Was that when we did it? like 2008, yeah. And so we did it, the three of us, and Wilco was on the bill, and I really wanted to cover Jesus, Etc. Had we already done it? We were already doing it. Or something. Anyway, so Wilco was on the bill. I was like, screw it. We're just going to do it. Even if they do it in their set. Let's just do it, you guys. They were going to do it, but they did it because we did it. Yeah.
That's when you first started playing that song, right?
It might have been because of that, because I was too nervous to do a Neil tune, so I decided to do a Wilco tune.
And then it ended up being like the most amazing decision.
It was so fun, because I was like, are you guys going to do Jesus, Etc.? Because I think we're going to do it. So in your face, you know? It was really funny. So we were joking around with Tweety, and then so we did it, and then they did it the same night. And then we did it again the next night, and I think they might have done it. We got to go see them open up for Neil at the Garden, and they asked us to come sing harmony on stage.
That's amazing.
Jeff said, and I was like, how much does something like that pay?
He goes, well, you can put your coats in our dressing room.
I played some of the Rambles with Move On. I was one of the subs, so I played bass up there. And I'd done a few records with him, and like he was just, I was sort of like a granddaddy to me. And then we ended up opening for a Rambles Pussy Boots. And we just had such a good time, and we all just loved Sosh. They had
and
such
you played his drums.
Yeah.
And I played his drums.
And he was just,
he told me to keep it up.
Yeah. He just wanted people to like,
after I cried and apologize.
That was like our second gig where you were playing drums.
Someone gave me an exotic cigarette after our show. I watched him play it, and I literally cried, and I thought, how could I do that, you know? And he was so kind, you know. Sonia Hunter. My friend is friends with Sonia. And this was when I first started playing guitar, right before I got the Fat Cat gig. And, you know, that was one of the songs she showed me. And I'm from the Bay Area, so I was like, it's a small circle. But her version, originally, is what kind of turned me on. Not any other version before that, but I know there's a few others. But we kind of made our own version. It's definitely, it's become like a little bit of a staple. I mean, it's funny because, I mean, lots of people, that's one of the songs we're like, God, I love this song. Mm-hmm. You know, it's kind of timeless.
Always wanted to cover Down by the River and play the guitar solo, but I never really had the guts to really do it. And then, but this is the perfect band to try something like that, so.
Yeah, what happened? One day you were like, hey, check it out.
I was like, you guys. Yeah, I was like, oh, you were at the drums. Yeah. You were at the drums because Sasha had only started playing drums about halfway through this band. And it was awesome because it really opened up the band to where it wasn't just like folky trio stuff all the time. So I was like, what about this? This is a slow groove. Maybe we could do this. And I started playing it and I was like, oh, crap. Because the chords aren't that hard. And we all sang it and we all knew it. So we all just kind of chimed in. And it was like one of our rare rehearsals. And then I was like, crap, I gotta do the guitar solo. So I started it, and it's pretty simple in the beginning. And I was like, just imitating Neil. And then,
so cool.
And then we ended up doing it live, and I kept working at the guitar solo, and I continued to work at the guitar solo. It sure is fun.
It's so much fun to push yourself and something you want to do. And the fact that people are enjoying hearing it,
people love that song.
I'm gonna go ahead and admit that I heard Doc Watson do that solo and literally did not know until we were coming up with the songwriting credits that it was actually Tom
Good
Paxton.
For you,
so
Kat.
Major props to Mr. Paxton. Doc Watson covered it, and I just sort of, I don't know, I hadn't really brought any songs to the table. I think that was the first one, and they loved it, and we all sing it in unison. It's a really special song. But yeah, Tom Paxton, like, I didn't hear that version until recently. I sent it to you guys.
And
it's so different, and so it's such unusual phrasing, really. But yeah, maybe one of my favorite songs ever. If it's just a bore, spread my blanket.